Congratulations on buying the executive version of this record. You have chosen wisely, and we value your discerning taste in deciding to pay the few extra pence for a product of real quality. Everything on this record has been designed to meet the exacting standards which you have naturally come to expect. The record itself is made from the very finest Colombian extruded polyvinyl. The center hole has been created to fit exactly onto your spindle with all the precision of finest Swiss craftsmanship. The audio content has been quality graded to give you the finest in listening pleasure. There is little or no offensive material apart from four cunts, one clitoris, and a foreskin. And as they only occur in this opening introduction, you're past them now. You can relax and enjoy this quality product, secure in the knowledge that it has been specially created for the lover of fine things and the man of good taste. Oh, sorry. You can edit that out, can't you?
Yeah, no problem.
The album of the soundtrack of the trailer of the film of Monty Python and the Holy Grail. Live from the classic Silbury Hills.
Hello and welcome to the classic Silbury Hill for the 3:10 performance of Monty Python and the Holy Grail. I can see through the door of the gentleman's that the B feature bring me the head of Don Reeve. There's only a few minutes left to run, just time for me to tell you a few quick words about the theatre. The Classic Silbury Hill, formerly the social club of the Andover Parks and Burials Department, was converted into a cinema in 1941 by Ken Polson, father of John, in the Gothic Renaissance style. The lavatories here comprise two freestanding fixtures and a 12-inch enamel wall bar with self-rinsing bar and auto-sump grill, and were opened by Gary Cooper in 1957. Well, I can see now Eunice and Maureen Zappa, salesgirls here through two walls and six different Tory administrations, making their way to the front of the auditorium with their sales trays full of ice creams, lollipops, sweets, dubbin and broken glass. There are several people in the audience this afternoon. This is an old-age pensioner's afternoon, and I can see Mrs. Skelton from the Customs and Excise in row G. And away there by the statue of Pan is Mr. Alway, the local Seamen's Union organiser. A surprise visitor is Mr. Bhutto, the president of Pakistan in row K. And up in the circle is Enid Pickles, local representative of the Baader-Meinhof group. She's the only one armed here this afternoon. Now, while the film Monty Python and the Holy Grail is being loaded into the huge projectors by Vincent Wong, the Sino-Scottish projectionist here at Silbury Hill, let's look back to that never-to-be-forgotten occasion when the film was premiered in London's busy West End. Bob Gandy is the reporter.
Hello and welcome to Old Compton Street. It's a mild night here, warm for early April, and a large crowd has gathered outside to watch this great gala night for the stars. Cars are arriving quite fast now. Here's a beautiful Rolls-Royce silver Corniche, all white, siding gracefully up to the doors of the cinema. Commissioner Alf Venables, ex-father of Terry, steps forward, opens the door, and out steps a radiant Miss Taylor herself, looking absolutely stunning in an off-the-shoulder organza and silk dress. And next comes Burt Reynolds in a huge red Ferrari sports car. Oh my God, Burt Reynolds has run into the back of the Corniche, and Miss Taylor turns and makes a splendid gesture. Great heavens, that's Steve McQueen, whose 18-gear Daytona Special has somersaulted through the air, piled into the back bumper of... And who's this coming through the windscreen of the Mini? Yes, it's lovely star Barbara Streisand, flying through the air in a beautiful Bill Gibb creation. And she's landed half on Roger Moore, looking quite well, and half on Jack Nicholson, who's not so well. And who's that under the back wheel? Yes, it's Faye Dunaway. No, it's Victor Mature in the blazing frock. Yes, all the stars are here tonight. That's Joan Crawford squashed in between the bonnet and Pete Murray and the box office door. And Shirley Temple, her head battered out of all recognition.
Oh, yes, a great galaxy of stars there. But now, here at the Classic, the lights are dimming. The film is about to commence. So, from the gentleman's rest room, over to my colleague, Dougie Nehru, in the rear stalls.
Welcome to the rear stalls. I'm in row T, just three seats along from the legendary seat 12. And now the titles are coming to an end as the film finally gets, well and truly, all your own.